This is Match Game 74, production number 0199. Air date to be announced, VT Yard 41574, take one.
Get ready to match the stars. Ron Messack, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Joanne Flood, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Fly as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you for joining us here, one and all. Nice to have you with us. Everybody okay?
Richard.
Fine. You've got a mustache. She paint that on you?
Yeah.
Mm. She did one to me yesterday. Boy, it sure was hard getting off.
Was it hard to get off?
There, hurt smarty. We tried lighter fluid and all kinds of acetone.
That's shaved.
This is indelible. You realize this stuff?
Oh, I really am sorry.
Okay, all is forgiven. Let's say hello to our champ, Donna Linnell. I want to point out to all assembled, and to Donna especially, that she's ready to have a go at the head-to-head. She'll be playing for $2,500, and if she is successful in that, she will be the new all-time money winner here on Match Game 74 by over $50. You'll be $50 over the previous high money winner. So, good luck to you, Donna. We'll begin that head-to-head match right after we pass along this message of interest. Okay, are you ready?
Ready.
All right, here we go. You won the $250. That means you are now playing for 10 times that amount, or $2,500. Remember, you've got to match one celebrity head-to-head, and it's time to choose one.
Joanne.
Okay, Joanne, you get ready to write, and Donna will face me. Here's the $2,500 question. Blank stop. S-T-O-P. Okay, she's finished. Now, what do you put in that blank in order to match Joanne? Blank stop.
Pit stop.
Pit stop. You like that answer? A lot of people in the audience like that answer. Let's find out now. For $2,500, Joanne, may we see your response?
Oh, my. The only time of stop that I know is a bus stop.
Bus stop. That's a very good answer.
Donna.
Do you know of anybody who drives racing cars?
No.
Pit stop is a racing car driver's term, isn't it?
Yeah, it is, but I don't know anybody.
Are you a racing car buff?
No.
What the heck did you say it for?
Well, it's the first thing that popped into my head.
First thing that popped into your head. Well, that's what we tell you. Trust your first judgment, and it usually works for you. That's the exception that proves the rule. Now, Donna, you picked up another $250. You're up to $12,150. You're going to meet another player. So let's welcome Pat Ladd. Hello there. Would you like to step up on the merry-go-round, please? Pat, you know Donna. Pat Lau, is that the way you say your name? Pat Lau. Okay. How are you?
I'm fine.
Good. You want to tell us a little bit about yourself?
Okay. I live in San Gabriel with my husband and three children, and I like to ski, and I'm trying to learn to play tennis.
How is that going?
It's a difficult... Well, I'm a perennial lesson taker.
Yeah.
I never play. I just take lessons.
Well, you got to play a lot in order to maintain and get some proficiency going there. All right, are you ready, Pat?
Yes.
I'll push a button and reveal these two questions, ask you the challenger to make a selection.
I think A.
All right, A. Brand new game, here we go. The Martian said to the galloping gourmet, "This is the most beautiful woman I ever saw." And the galloping gourmet said, "That's no woman, that's my blank."
You run that up the flagpole again.
All right, one more time for you, Charles. The Martian said to the galloping gourmet, "This is the most beautiful woman I ever saw." And the galloping gourmet said, "That's no woman, that's my blank."
Hi, sweetheart.
How are you?
I love you with a rash.
Little,
he doesn't have a rang.
Yeah, but it stings a
it
lot,
will,
though.
Honey, don't
I want
worry.
You to suffer a lot in there. Okay, upper tier is ready and the lower tier is ready. So we'll call on Pat here. The Martian said to the Galloping Gourmet, "This is the most beautiful woman I ever saw." And the Galloping Gourmet said, "That's no woman, that's my...
wife."
"That's no woman, that's my wife." Okay, her answer is wife. What do you say, Ron?
I wish I had said wife or something. I said, "That's no..." I don't even know if I spelled it right, but "That's no woman, that's my dessert."
My dessert.
Yes.
Some tasty dish there. All right.
That's rather suggestive.
Is that Brett? What do you say?
I say his mother-in-law made that shirt, and after the way he spelled dessert, she's gone off him for life.
That's a beautiful shirt.
Isn't that a pretty shirt?
Yes, very
attractive. Your mother-in-law don't like you no more.
I wrote desert.
What did you have?
I said moose, as in desert.
Moose.
You don't know how to spell mouse.
I think everybody missed
moose,
the point here.
Mousse, moose, as in chocolate mousse, coffee mousse.
Yeah, you missed the point, too. All right, Charles, what did you say?
A cucumber mousse is lovely on a cold afternoon. I said pot.
Pot.
That's my silly.
No one got it. No one gets it. I don't know. You can't say
it.
Go ahead. Yeah.
Well, everyone knows when you learn how to cook and you become a gourmet, you cook souffles.
Oh.
I'm sorry, but
maybe I missed the point of the question.
Right.
I don't know.
Read the question again.
No, I was thinking the Martian said to the Galloping Gourmet, "This is the most beautiful woman I ever saw." And the Galloping Gourmet said, "That's no woman, that's my refrigerator."
That's not right.
Her answer is the best.
Actually, what is the was?
Who?
What?
"That's no woman, that my Jell-O mold." And let that be a lesson to you. Jimmy takes less.
All right, Fanny, this is one time when it may not be a disadvantage to be last.
Oh, yes, it is. I put, "That's no woman, that's my stuffed turkey."
Wasn't that a rotten question? Okay, so it's none for you and none for me and none for them, and this for you, so watch carefully. All right, here we go. Now, we're going to finish this round, and we've got this for you. Are you ready for us?
Okay.
Okay, here we go. As soon as you walk into Pete's living room, you know he's an airline pilot because he has blanks on his couch. You're not too thrilled with that, are you, audience? I thought it was interesting. As soon as you walk into Pete's living room, you know he's an airline pilot because he has blanks on his couch.
Change.
You may change your mind. Do it quickly, though. All right, ready here. Charles ready, Brett's ready, and Ron is ready, right?
Yes.
Okay. Now, Donna, as soon as you walk into Pete's living room, you know he's an airline pilot because he has blanks on his couch.
Wings.
Wings. Is this the girl who won $12,150 who tells me wings on a couch? Ron, what do you say?
You know how dumb an answer I thought that was, Donna? That's the one I changed. I said I've been married so long that I... Who would ever put...
You mean you wrote wings and you threw it away?
Yeah, but I put steward eye because he was a single pilot.
Oh, steward eye. Yeah. Okay. Brett?
Well, I was thinking about Charles's teeth and I put caps.
Caps on his couch?
You know,
the airline caps. Oh, yes, right.
I don't feel so
yes,
dumb.
Sir.
No.
Okay. Okay. Charles?
I, of course, am perfect.
Yes. Okay. He is, too, you know.
Oh, I know he is. He slays me.
How about you? Are you a perfect person?
I'm perfect, too.
Yes.
But I don't correspond. I'm sorry. I put stews, which is short for stewardess.
All right.
Steward
eye. Right.
Exactly.
And you, sir, what did you put?
If it's the last thing I ever did.
Steward eye.
Now, they are short steward eye. Fanny, she's looking for the word wings.
I know she.
You can tell he's an airline pilot because he has blanks on his couch. What do you say?
I wanted to say seat numbers. But I said stewardess along with my
stewardess.
Friend.
Stewardess. Apparently that's what everybody thought and said. Okay, now let's go to round two, shall we? There are the questions. Pat, would you make a selection?
Oh, I guess I'll try A again.
You want to try A again? Wasn't too good to you last time, was it? Let's see how we do this time. At the South Pole, it is against the law for a man to blank a penguin. At the South Pole. for a man to blank a penguin. It's against the law for a man to blank a penguin. I don't know how that is in the North Pole, but this is the way it is at the South Pole. There are no penguins at the North Pole, I guess.
Oh, I guess it is.
The South Pole, this is a lot of penguins at the South Pole. They're southern, right. Southern. Right. Charles, you ready? Okay. You had a little trouble with that, right? Okay, here we go. Pant. At the South Pole, it is against the law for a man to blank a penguin.
Right. Date a penguin.
Date a penguin. She says there's a law on the South Pole that says you can't date no penguins. And Ron's talking to himself.
Well, I was thinking about the South Pole and dates, and when you go on a date with a penguin, you're not allowed to rub noses.
It's against the law to rub noses with a penguin.
They don't kiss out there, folks.
That's right. Brett?
Have you ever been there, dear?
Yeah.
Well, actually, they can date them, but they must not marry.
Can't marry. That no match there. Okay, okay.
Thank you, Mom.
Kiss all right. A penguin.
Charles says kiss.
A penguin.
Gee, you're getting close, but so far, no match. Let's see what you've got.
I'm very humane. I said shoot.
Shoot. Against the law to shoot a penguin.
Yes.
Good straight answer. Richard?
It's against the law.
Yes.
To love a penguin.
To love a penguin. Uh-oh. Pat, you're going to have to match Fanny to stay in the game.
I said it was against the law to eat a penguin.
All right. So Donna wins another game. Congratulations. Sorry, Pat. It's a real pleasure meeting you. You're a lovely lady, and we've got a gift for you, together with our thanks for being with us at Match Game 74. Pat Lau. Well, here we go again, Donna. You ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, we polled a recent studio audience, got their best response to this. Blank Bailey. You know, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. If you match the next one, $250, and the bottom $100. Whom do you want?
Joanne.
Pearl
Bailey, she said. Okay.
Richard.
Gentleman who won't come home, Bill Bailey.
Bill Bailey. Won't come home, Bill Bailey.
Charles.
Charles.
Ringling Brothers Barnum and. And if you can get your mustache off, they can get all of that on that first one at the bottom.
That's right. It wasn't easy. All right. Now, you got Ringling Brothers Barnum and, you've got Pearl, and you've got Bill. Whom do you choose?
Pearl.
You choose Pearl Bailey. Okay, that's Joanne's answer, and one we're looking for. We'll find out if it's up there right now. First, may we see the $100 response. Beetle Bailey.
Have I ever lied to you before?
No. Is that what you thought of? Beetle Bailey.
He
okay.
Said Beetle Bailey, and
what
I said,
position
who is
that? Did he play?
Here we go. Looking for the answer, Pearl Bailey. May we see the $250 response? Pearl Bailey it is. Congratulations. Okay, so you've picked up another $250, and before we go on here, let's find out what's under the $500 response. What do you think? Bill Bailey. Bill Bailey finally did come home. All right, now you've got the $250. That means you're playing again for 10 times that amount, or... Bing.
Bing, I'm sorry,
$2,500. Please keep your bings going here, because he may forget back there. Now, whom do you choose?
Joanne.
All right, Joanne, you get ready to write, and here we go again.
Why is this done?
$2,500. Chow blank. That's C-H-O-W blank. Chow blank. Okay, now, she's answered hers, and we need a response from you in a way you think will match her. What do you say?
Chow mein.
Chow mein. Okay. If you do match her, I guess you will be the new high money winner here for $2,500. Joanne, may we see your response?
Chinese food. I always eat chop suey.
Chop suey?
But I put mein.
Chow mein! Congratulations.
$15. $15,000 is a new all-time high money winner. You stand right here, and we'll come back to you right after this message. Today's consolation prizes are Lady Schick Lasting Curls Hair Setter, the quick way to longer-lasting curls. Beautifying this moisturizes your hair while setting from Schick. And skincare products from Baum Bar, cocoa butter, vitamin E, wheat germ, lotion, and oil. Nail growth for problem nails. Baum Bar for lovelier skin. And a great taste treat, Fifth Avenue Candy Bars. Luscious milk chocolate and almonds. Fifth Avenue, one of America's favorite butter bars. Try to fill in the next blank on Match Game 74 in a minute.
We're ready to play a new game, and to do that, we're pleased to present a new player. Here's Mary Strauss. Hello, Mary.
Hi.
You know Donna?
Yes.
Tell us the story of Mary Strauss.
Well, I have two little girls, and I'm married, and he's in the audience, and they're 2 and 3 years old.
Okay. Are you ready for this?
No.
No?
I'm nervous.
Take a deep breath, Mary. See, now you're not nervous. I'll push a button and we'll get right to it and ask you to make a selection. Which one do you want? B. Okay, here we go. New game. As they led Frankie to the electric chair, the warden asked him for his last request. And Frankie said...
I know.
No, you don't know. Frankie said, Warden, could you hold my blank?
You know what I thought it was
going to
be? That old song, Tell Laura I Love Her.
All right. Ready over here?
Philip. Me.
Warden, could you hold my... Okay, now we're all set. Mary Strauss. As they led Frankie to the electric chair, the warden asked him for his last request. And Frankie said, Warden, could you hold my...
Hand.
Take my hand.
You dirty rat.
Yeah, what? Did he hold his hand?
He certainly did.
Hold his hand. There's one hand for you, Mary. Brett?
Take my hand.
All right, you're rolling now, Mary. Charles?
One good hand is earned.
Okay. Could you hold my seat for me, Warden? I'll be right back. What did you say?
Tell Laura I love her.
Tell Laura I love her. All right. Okay.
To the guy in the chair, any advice? He said, yeah, don't sit down.
Hand. Okay. And Fanny, do you make it unanimous? First round question in a long time. I mean, that's most unusual. You got your work cut out for you. You'll have two chances to catch up to her. She's matched everyone. Now this. The surgeon trimmed his front hedge to look like a giant blank. The surgeon trimmed his front hedge to look like a giant blank. The surgeon.
Don't worry.
He's okay. You leave him alone now.
Love your mother-in-law's shirt.
I love your mother-in-law.
I certainly hope so.
Okay, now we're all set. Donna, we call on you. The surgeon trimmed his front hedge to look like a giant...
Stethoscope.
That would be a most ambitious topiary project. What do you say?
Donna, if I couldn't spell dessert, how am I going to spell stethoscope? I was thinking of love thoughts and Valentine's Day. I put a heart.
Heart. Yes. Okay. Not a bad idea. Brett?
Darling, they like to hack people to death. Surgeons, no offense, doctor. Scalpel.
That would be good. Charles.
They just like to hack some people together. Scalpel.
Scalpel it is. All right. She's looking for stethoscope. The surgeon trimmed his front hedge to look like a giant stethoscope, she says. What do you say?
Oh, I said an
operating table.
Oh, that would be, yeah, that could be done. Yes, indeed.
I thought it was very good, didn't you?
Yes, quite good. I thought it was splendid.
Oh, no.
Very, very nice.
Very nice. What do you say, Richard?
A giant tonsil.
Oh, that'd be good. That's a good one.
Who cares?
Isn't that a good one, Fanny? What do you say, Fan?
Tonsil. It was a kidney.
Kidney. So, 6-0 is the score at the end of round one here. Now we've got to stop and do a little business, and then you hurry right back and see what happens. Okay, ladies, time is up. We finished round one. It's 6-0. Favor the challenger. You got your work cut out for you. And next time, you'll start cutting out. What's the name of your movie of the week?
It's called Archer.
And who's going to be on that?
Well, it's a pilot for Peter Graves, and they have a very unique, outstanding cast like Dame Judith Anderson and Celeste Holmes and Jack Klugman.
Don't you love the way she gives him last billing?
I didn't give him last billing at all. He was terrific. And Jim Hutton's
three.
Terrific.
Basics.
We'll look forward to seeing that.
Very good.
And what's the name of your movie again?
The one that's going to start production in July is called The Sons of Erin.
What's that mean?
And it's about an Irish family.
And you wrote it, and you're starring in it.
I'm going to be one of the five.
Now listen, you've been on my show.
Yes.
Now what about?
Gene, I've seen you working with a mustache. But okay. Not yeah, sure.
No. Listen, I'm only kidding.
Fine. No, I can listen. Can you hold the reins?
Mustache. Gene Rayburn for Match Game 74. Join us next time. Thank you.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 74. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of these CBS stations.